Have you ever come across a situation where you have copied and pasted data from someplace else? So let's say from an email or a web page into an Excel sheet, and then you realize any formula you write that references this range gives you errors. You dig deeper and do some research, and you find out that one common cause for this type of error is probably because there are unwanted spaces there, like leading spaces or trailing spaces that were copied when you brought the data to Excel. You find out that you can use Excel's trim function to remove these additional spaces. You do that, and it works 90% of the time. Everything is great until it stops to work. You copy a data set to your Excel sheet, apply the trim function like you've always done, but this time, trim doesn't work. Let me show you what does. So here in the second example, the trim function wasn't able to remove the space. Why? The formula looks like it's working. Let's just double check what this part of the formula returns. I'm just going to highlight it, press F9 to see what's behind it. Notice that we still have that space, even though I'm using the trim function. So I'm just going to press escape to leave the formula. Now, trim can remove spaces, but it can remove certain type of spaces. These are spaces that have a character code or an ASCII character code of 32. There is another character code that represents a space, which is commonly referred to as a non-breaking space. The character code for that is 160. Now, these ASCII character codes are what's used by computer programs to identify what character you're referring to. So for example, if I just add a space here and press enter, and I want to see what character code is associated with the space, I can type the function code, reference the cell, close the parentheses, and press enter. Character code of a regular space is 32. Let's copy the character space that we have here. Let's paste it in here. Drag down the code function. This time we get a character code of 160. This is a non-breaking space, and it's something you're going to come across if you're copying data from Outlook or you're bringing in data from other external systems into Excel. They might not all have the character code 32, they might be 160. Now, there is an Excel formula that gives us the actual character back once we have the code, and that's called the character formula. So if I reference 32 here, I actually get back a normal space and here a non-breaking space. We can see that if I copy these and paste these as values and I go inside the cell, there is a space here, and in the other one, we see a space. Now, to our eyes, both of these look like regular spaces, but to the computer's eye, they're not. The trim function removes these. It can't remove this one. It would be great if Excel had a trim all function, and maybe that's going to come in the future, which can trim out both of these characters. But for now, it doesn't. So what we need to do is use the substitute function, look for this non-breaking space, and replace it with nothing. So instead of trim here, we're going to use substitute. Now, the substitute function has more arguments because first we need to reference the cell we want to transform, then old text that we want to replace. So in this case, it's our non-breaking space. To make sure we get it right, we're going to type in the character code for it, which was 160. Then the new text that we want to replace it with, well, it's nothing. So I'm just going to skip that argument and press enter, and I get back the correct description from the table. Now let's send this down. It works for these, it doesn't work for this. What's wrong here? Let's highlight this, press F9 to see if we still have a space. We still have a space. So I substituted the non-breaking space, but this one looks like it has a regular space as well. So it would make sense to also use the trim function on top of the substitute function. Now let's send this down. Everything works. But wait a second, what about the data? Can we just sum these up? Let's use the sum function, gives me zero. It doesn't recognize that these are numbers. Now, there seems to be a non-breaking space before these. Usually, if you have a regular space and you have numbers in Excel cells, you can directly use the value function on the cell to get the actual number back. But the value function doesn't work. What if I use the trim function and then the value function on top of that? Will this work? It doesn't work. So here what I need to do is use the substitute function again. So let's try that. Old text is this one. New text, what was the character code? 160. New text is nothing, so we can just leave this out. Close bracket, press enter. This looks like a clean number, but it's actually not a number, right? Because it's left aligned and not right aligned. Excel still sees this as text. So now let's put this inside the value function, and now it looks like it's a number. Drag these down. Now let's get the sum for these. So I'll just copy and paste this, and it works, right? So whenever you come across situations where your numbers are not recognized as numbers, and you use the trim function, it doesn't work. You use the value function, it doesn't work. Remember to use the substitute function. Look for the character code 160 and replace it with nothing. Now you might want to do all of this in one single step instead of creating helper cells like I've done here. Let's try it here. We're just going to combine all of this in one formula. So just to keep things simple, I'm just going to copy this formula, paste it here. Instead of referencing just C9, let's reference the entire range here. This formula in the new dynamic array Excel will spill and give us actually what we see here. To make it not spill, we're going to put it in the sum function because sum is just going to return one result. Now, if I press enter, it's going to work for me because I have the new dynamic array aware Excel. If you don't have the new version of Excel, instead of pressing enter, what you need to do is press Control Shift Enter and yours will work just like mine does. Just going to drag the formula across, works for this as well. So that's how you can remove blank spaces from your Excel lists. I hope you found this video useful. If you did, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe to this channel if you haven't subscribed already so that you can get updates when I put out new videos here. And I'll see you in the next video.